Hi students, so I hope you are doing well. Today we are going to talk something very interesting and another topic of fourth chapter, that is cognitive process. So before going ahead, I want you all to solve this puzzle. The goal of the puzzle is to link all the 9 dots using the 4 straight lines or fewer, without lifting the pen and without tracing the same line more than once. So I want you all to solve this puzzle as fast as you can. So you don't need to repeat those lines. You don't have to lift up your pen. And you need to join all the dots, all the 9 dots together. So either of you have got the solution, that is as making a sleeping S or making a G. And very few of students must have got a solution which is something out of the box. If you have thought like this, the solution for joining the 9 dots, then you have a special kind of thinking, or your thought process or your cognitive process is very much different. We will move ahead with another problem. What do you think you can do with this bottle? You feel like cutting the black line, and what it will be helpful for? Creativity loading. You're still thinking over it. Think, what can you make out of this particular plastic bottle? Did you got any solution to it? So we will see what kind of solution you have brought up. So this is what that can be made of this plastic bottle. After cutting a bottle, you will get a mobile stand holder. Okay. So what is happening over here? If you have thought that it would be something related to stand, or something that would hold any particular object, then you were thinking was creative. So that is what our today's topic is, creative thinking. Now we all know what creative word means or what creativity is. It means that something new or something very creative the person is trying to create. So it is mostly related to the arts and the science things, where the people start creating lots of new stuff. Okay, so we are going to discuss how this creative thinking actually works. So creativity lies with these words like thinking, original, positive, genius, mind, ideas, lots of inventions, lots of innovation, lots of brainstorming, lots of illumination, solutions, and something which is very much new. So all these words are related to creativity. So if we say someone is doing an invention, it means his brain is working in the way of creativity. His thought process is having creativity. Okay, so let's understand what creative thinking is. Creativity is characterized by the ability of perceive the world in a new ways, to find the hidden patterns, to make connection between seemingly unrelated phenomena, and to generate the solutions. So what they are saying is, creativity is our ability to perceive the world in very new ways, in a very different way. We try to find out the what is lying between the patterns, what is going on around the world. We try to make connection between something which is unrelated, and we try to generate the various solutions. So this is known as creative thinking. Scientists, musicians, poets, fashion designer, interior decorator, etc. always think in a creative way. Creative thinking seems to be having following four sequential stages. So these are the professions which have creative thinking. There are other professions as well where creative thinking take place. So can you name some of the professions that require creative thinking? Can you think about them? Okay, so the person working in mass media, advertisement, movie, film industry, right? These all people have a creative thinking. And any other, like artists, are also creative thinkers. So many professions require a creative thinking. If things are not creative, so if there are nothing new things coming up, then people will get bored of it. Okay, so even in technologies, we can see there are lots of creative things that are being added. We will take a simple example of a speaker. Okay, earlier speaker were very huge and they were very heavy, right? And even it was very difficult to carry those speakers in a place, from place to place. Now with this technology and with the creative thinking, now we can use Bluetooth speakers, we can use Bluetooth earphones for ourselves, right? And why this happened? It happened because of the creative thinkers who thought something out of the box. Same way we can say for the automobile industries. Okay, earlier the cars were very dull in designs, and now you can see that they have shown the updates. So these are all the part of creative thinking. So you can see in our life, we keep on using this creative thinking to make it look more beautiful. So these are the four stages that we are going to discuss. The first stage of creative thinking is preparation. So we are seeing how this creative thinking exactly works. So preparation, it is the stage of formulating the problem and gathering the information, materials, etc. for finding a new solutions. Creative ideas do not come from a vacuum. Many tentative solutions are tried out and discarded. No progress seems to be made in this stage. The first stage of creative thinking is preparation, wherein all the information about any particular problem is been gathered. All the solutions are on the basis of our thought process and whatever information we can collect. So all this are been prepared. Okay. For example, if a poet wants to write a song for a particular movie, he may start preparing for it by brainstorming, reading, gathering his own past experiences, or anything that can help him to move towards finding a new solution. So in preparation, what happens over here, poet is doing a preparation to write a new song. So what he will do is, he is going to gather all the data, all the material, reading material and everything to get prepared for writing a new poem, right? So this is the first stage of creative thinking, that is preparation. Fine. Can you tell me what kind of preparation example you can give me? Any example for preparation? So if we take an example of COVID-19, so scientists, what they are doing to prepare a vaccine for COVID? They are preparing, they are doing the preparation. So they are collecting all the data right now. Okay. So that is known as preparation for any so problem to bring out the solution. Next is incubation. After preparation, a person starts working on the problem but may not get required solutions. This initial failure leads to the stage of incubation. So what happens in the incubation stage is that after doing a preparation and lot of hard work, the person finally gives up, he gets frustrated and he leaves the work there and there and he focuses on his daily routine. Okay, so that particular period is known as incubation because in the preparation stage, he didn't found a solution to his problem. So he is just leaving his work then and there and he is focusing on unrelated problems. Okay, so this period is known as incubation period, which comes always in the creative thinker's mind. Okay, so during the stage, the person is so frustrated that he, she thinks of giving up. The person then leaves the problem and focuses on other things which are unrelated to the problem. Incubation may help the person to work on the problem without consciously thinking about it. This period, though, appears to be non-fruitful, is followed by the period of sudden appearance of solution. So what happens, the person leaves the work and he focuses on unrelated problems. Okay, so when he leaves that particular work, although he is leaving that work consciously, but his brain unconsciously is trying to find the solution to the problem. And although this stage seems to be unfruitful, but it is the most fruitful stage because only after this stage, the person finds the solution to the problem. So the next we are going to see, here is the example of incubation period. For example, a poet may start writing some lines for his new poem, but may feel that the lines written are inappropriate. He may write for 2 days straight, then may give up and then may not write for weeks. During these weeks of incubation, he may follow his routine like going to gym, eating, watching movie, talking to friends, etc. So this is what incubation period looks like. He leaves his writing in the middle for few weeks and he carries out his routine like going to gym, eating, watching movie, etc. And he has went into the incubation period, right? Next is illumination. After incubation, suddenly like a flash of light, the correct solution appears in the front of mind's eye and the person experiences a rush of excitement. All the bits and the pieces of the ideas which appeared to be unrelated earlier fall in the place. The solution that appears is nearly next to perfect. A person experiences an emotional reaction of joy, knowing that he, she has found a new idea or solution. So this is what happens in illumination stage, which comes after an incubation period. So in illumination stage, when the person has left a war to find the solution to the problem, he gets a sudden quick idea about how to fix the particular problem. Okay, so it comes in the mind of the person all of a sudden, and it gives him a kind of excitement that he has found the solution to the problem. Okay, so that is known as the illumination stage. So what happens, the solution that he finds in the illumination stage is very much perfect, and the person's reaction is very emotional, because all those weeks where he was trying to find the solution, he was not getting the solution, right? So when he left that particular problem, his mind was unconsciously solving that particular problem, and then all of a sudden the illumination occurred and he got a proper solution to the problem. So for example, a poet will suddenly find the exact lines that he was searching for weeks together. This will be aha moment for him. So this would be like a astonishing moment for the poet, because he has found the solution without even knowing about it. Like he got the solution all of a sudden. Okay, so that is the illumination stage of creative thinking. The last stage of creative thinking is verification. Following the euphoria of previous stage, euphoria means happiness, extreme happiness, the new solution still needs to be tested. In most cases, it requires only minor changes, but sometimes it may require a lifetime to study, test, and result. So, in verification, once the person has got a solution through illumination stage, he would just make slight changes in those solution, and then he will conclude those solutions to it. Okay, so that is known as a verification. For example, a poet will write his new poem on a paper, will read it again and again, and will check whether any word line is still to be changed. So these were the four stages of creative thinking that we saw. These were, first one was preparation, wherein the person prepares all the material for any creative thinking. Second one was incubation, where the person gives up and he follows his daily routine. And then we saw the third stage, that is illumination, where the person gets a sudden solution to this problem, right? And the last one is verification, where he makes a minor changes of his solutions, and then he he solves the problem appropriately. Okay, so these were the four stages of creative thinking. In case if you have any doubts, please feel free to comment in this video and let me know whether you liked it or no. Thank you so much. Bye. Take care.